Hello everyone, this is Dr. Shochinandan Datta, and in this course, the Integrated Coastal Zone Management, today I'll talk about more about the introduction to ICJDM. So this is the part 2 video. In the part 1 video, we have seen the what is the coastal zone and more about the coastal zones and the threats of the coastal zone. And in this lecture, we will talk about more on the coastal zone management and also the ICJDM and the integration, different integration, and also the principle of ICJDM. So first of all, we have to look at the what is coastal zone management. So last video we have seen the coastal zone. Here we will see the coastal zone management. So coastal zone management basically involves the managing the coastal areas, managing the coastal area, and that is not only the managing the coastal area, as well as in support you have to balance the environment, you have to balance the economy, human health and human activities. So it is more about an integrated approach or the multidisciplinary approach. So it's not that you are only managing the resources, you have to manage the environment, economy, social and human activity. So this is more about the sustainable approaches, okay. And CJDM or coastal zone management basically integrate the biological, physical and biological processes. So any kind of biological processes or the physical processes and political processes, and to plan and execute sustainable solution for the environmental challenges where the land meets water and the coastal zone. So it's more about the sustainability. So there is a three angle of sustainability. One is the ecology, one is the economy, and one is the social. So when these three things meet together, then that is called a sustainable approach. So whenever we are preparing any sustainable management of any natural resources, then we have to think about the all the three things together. So what is integrated coastal zone management? So ICJDM or integrated coastal zone management, it is the process of management of the coast using an integrated approach. So integrated approach, that's mean all together. So regarding all aspect of the coastal zone, it's not the only one aspect. So all aspect of the coastal zone, including geographical and political boundaries, and the main attempt to achieve that is the sustainability. Just I have talked about the sustainability, and it is a dynamic process, it is a multidisciplinary approach, it is an iterative process, and it's promote the sustainable management of coastal zone. So we have to think about all the aspects of the coastal zone. It could be economically, it could be politically, or it could be socially, or it could be ecological, every aspect, okay. And it covers the full cycle of information, basically collection information, then we have to make a plan, mean planning, then decision making by the policy maker, and then management, and after doing this thing, the most important thing, the monitoring and implementation. So there will be lots of the rules and regulation, but implementation is the major impact that could be make the thing is sustainable, okay. And the concept of ICJDM basically born in the Earth Summit in the Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, in 1992, and it was taken on that Earth Summit in as a Agenda 21. The ICJDM is considered in this Earth Summit. Now talk about the integration. What is integration? So integrated coastal zone management. So integration basically bringing together and mixing together or combining. So it's all together. So it's not about the one approach and creating something new. So integration means creating something new, bringing together, mixing together or combining all together. So integrated in coastal zone management, it is basically the combined interest of aiming to satisfy different needs. So we know that the coastal zones has multiple uses of coastal zone, okay. And it has a huge importance to the human life. 70% of the population lies within the day walk distance. And so traditionally approach, what was the traditional approach? We are basically manage in different ecosystem or different things in separately. But this traditional approach, just suppose in a estuary region, you have to manage the wetland separately, you have to manage the estuary separately, you also managing the dune separately, but ICJDM is all together. Okay, you have to manage all together. An integrated approach would manage the link between these NCR activities in one place, and two most important things, that there will be no negative impact, no negative impact of any angle. So we are we are considering the environment, but we are not considering the economy, but we are not considering also social. So that is also not a sustainable approach. Sustainable approach means you have to consider all together, and there will be no negative impact to any of your component. Okay. And so integration are different types. We will see the horizontal integration and the vertical integration. Horizontal integration is more about the same. Okay, so it's across the same sector, managing and see the common problem. And you cannot avoid the giving things of one sector to another sector, and preference to over one. You are much more preference one sector, and another sector you are not giving preference. So that is not a integrated app. So horizontal integration means the all the sector in a common problem, but same at the same level. So many different, like common example, fisheries and tourism, fisheries and forest, tourism and forest. So these are the all are in a same angle, and you have to consider fisheries as well as the tourism. Okay, so many areas of conflict, there will be huge conflict between the fishing or the forest, between the fishing and tourism, but here management should be combined interest, where both you have to consider both of them. Okay, and minimizing the conflict through the spatial planning and other means. Okay, so you have to make a proper plan, and it could be spatial planning that you have to manage both the things in together. And what is the vertical integration? Vertical integration is much more about the strata, okay, in different level. Okay, just it's basically coming from the government sector, like you are making a things in management plan for the whole country, management plan for the whole means a province, management plan maybe a district level, management plan maybe a village level, or management plan maybe a particular area, region or level. So it's have a level. So vertically it have so it could be a top down and bottom up approaches. Okay, and ensure link between policies and practices. So policies and practices, you have to make a link. So it could not be that you are preparing a plan for the country or for the whole province, but you are not considering the problem of that particular region or village or particular district. Okay, so you have to consider all the level. Okay, so improve administrative, you have to do the less conflict between the level of government. So it's not that the village level government there is a conflict with the central. Okay, there will be conflict between the district to the village. So that could not be. Okay, and similar policies adopted across the country. So similar policies you have to take across all the level. Okay, all the strata. And greater effectiveness of the government. So that's why you, if you making a policy or plan for all those data equally, then there will be it's much more effective. Okay, and the better public relationships, that is good. Some people who are in the village, so they could not think that our problem is not considered in this plan or in this management plan, but the problem of the center or the province is considered. So there will be conflict. So that should be avoided. So plans should be same for all the level. Then the another two types, that the spatial integration and the scientific integration. Spatial integration means according to space. As we have checked this thing, that the coastal zone is a different aspect, okay, and it is used for different industrial purposes or different business. Okay, so managing across administrative boundaries, so it's not that a industry are here is a tourism, here and here is a recreation tourism, so you have to make all together. Managing across physical boundary, it could be land, sea or river is coming, made the ocean, so estuary, river, everything you have to consider. And reflect the natural environment processes and human impact, how it's impacting the environment. Okay, And scientific integration, that is basically a transdisciplinary approach. We know that it's an interdisciplinary, transdisciplinary approach, and combine the discipline to form a new approaches. And integration means it could be traditional or it could be scientific knowledge. So managing the resources, maybe we are using traditional knowledge and maybe using the scientific knowledge. So that is the main thing. The integration of the local people is also much more important in terms of preparing any plan. And difficulty, it could be difficult, but you have to minimize your difficulty, make it much more comfortable for all the level. Now the driving force, this is important, that what are the driving force are preparing, means are there in preparing the ICDM plan. So behind the devastating coastal resources depletion, so I have talked about that, how different the threats of the coastal zones. And that many countries are suffering the several major driving force. What are the major driving force that are basically a reason to depletion of the coastal resources, including some areas of the misunderstanding. Example of these forces are listed here. You can check the what are the driving forces. So high rates of population growth. So population growth is, as we know, that coastal zone is much more populated area. Okay, so if the coastal zone is population is increasing, that the it's difficult to manage. Okay, so it's then one of the driving force. The population growth can be impacting your preparation plan or impact on the coastal resources also. Okay, and poverty exacerbated and by declining resources. So if the poverty will be there, then could be the resource could be declined. Okay, and degraded the fisheries habitat. So we are much more hampering on the natural ecosystem. We're much more hampering to the fisheries habitat by capturing the fingerlings or capturing the or maybe the ecosystem may be degraded due to the unproper or unsustainable fishing, and lack of alternative livelihood. If you are not providing, if you ban of a particular area for the fishing, then you should also provide an alternative livelihood to the fishermen. Okay, if you ban for a particular time period for the fishing of a particular region, then you have to also provide a particular or different alternative livelihood for that time period. Okay, and large scale and quick profit. So that is very important, that the for the business purposes, for commercial purposes, we are going to is immediate profit. So that immediate profits of commercial enterprise, it's much more harmful to the resources. Okay, it's much more degraded the resources, and it makes a conflict with the interest of the local people. So if you allow these resources for the business purpose, that is hampering the resources as well as the that much more conflicting with the local people. So you are not taking care of the local people means demand. Okay, and lack of awareness about the management and the resource sustainability by the policymaker and the local people. So local people and the policymaker, they are not much more aware about the what is the sustainable approach of management of resources. Okay, and a lack of understanding of economic contribution and the coastal resources to the society. So we don't know that we have a huge resources, we are extracting everything, but we are not aware about the that economic contribution that are coming from the coastal resources, and that is basically society are getting lots of the resources from the coastal zone. That is not that everybody is aware. And a lack of serious government follow-up. So follow-up is much more important. Government makes a law, regulation, everything, but follow-up is much more important, and implementation. Okay, so follow-up in support, that follow-up should be in support of the conservation program and the enforcement of the conservation program. So if you are planning to prepare one example, just Ras Al Khaimah, okay, that's basically you are planning to prepare a management plan for the turtle nesting. So that conservation program, your turtle conservation program you are taking, and but you are initially you are taking very seriously, later on you are not follow up, later on you are not implemented your law regulation, so that could be harmful. Okay, and until such forces of are upset, and there is a little hope for or accomplish environmental conservation and the resource sustainability. That is the main approach of any kind of sustainable approach to making the resource sustainable. And what are the benefits we are getting from the ICJDM? So there is a lots of benefit we are getting from the ICJDM. It's basically minimize the project implementing cost. Okay, if any project we are going to implement in the coastal zone, so if you have a proper plan, it's basically help you to minimize your cost and minimize the demand of the marine environment and its resources. So if you have a proper ICJDM plan, then you also minimize the demand of coastal or marine resources, or minimize the means pressure on the marine environment. You are not extracting a lot, so over exploitation could be managed properly, and the minimize losses of various users. So users are could be local people to different users. We are also everywhere. Every people are taking resources from the coastal zone, so that the resource depletion and also the access limitation means you cannot access everything. So that's unsustainable. Over exploitation is you can manage it, okay? And if you have a proper plan and make a most efficient use of infrastructure, okay? If you are preparing a infrastructure in the ICJDM area, means in the coastal zone area, then if you have a proper plan, then you can use it, or you can efficiently you can make your infrastructure. And information technology is also available to the marine development sector. So whatever you are preparing in the marine zone or the coastal zone, then if the information is available in the open forum, then it is much more easy to make the plan also, and much more easy to understanding what is happening by all the level of people. And it's also benefits within the benefits. It's also facilitated the sustainable economic growth based on the natural resources. If you have properly managed, then it can be long lasting. It gives you much more profitable. So it's not that we are extracting the whole fisheries at a time. Okay, if you are taking the fisheries for, then that could be, decline in the near future. But if you are extracting the fisheries in a regular basis, in a sustainable approach, then it could be last long, okay? Then that could be gives you much more profit in long term, okay? And conserving the natural habitat and species. So if you have proper plan, that could be much more important for the conservations of habitat as well as the species. Controlling the pollution and alternative soil land and the beach fund. So pollution that can be directly coming from the industrial or the domestic soil, that could be properly treated, and then you have to discharge into the soil line. And controlling the watershed activities and adversely affect the coastal zone. So water, we'll talk about later, the how the water is much more important in the coastal zone. And controlling excavation, mining, and or coral mining is, and the sand mining is also biggest threat to the coastal zone. So mining and the coral reef production, water basin and the sea floor, so that you have to make a proper control. You can, if you have a proper ICJDM plan, then you can control on those things, okay? And it's basically rehabiting or restoring the degraded resources. If you have a proper, like that, lots of the mangrove ecosystem are degrading. So if you have a proper ICJDM plan, then you can make a means restore that particular mangrove ecosystem, which are much more important for all the level, so important for the society as well as the ecosystem. And providing a mechanism or tool that could be for rational or resource allocation. So resource should be allocated properly and in a way that it should be reached to everyone in a equitable resource partitioning, okay? So all this require basically coordination. You require coordination and for their accomplishment, and that's why you need a ICJDM that could be fulfilled. Now the basic principle, few principle for the ICJDM. What are the basic principle? Basically, coastal zones are basically unique, okay, and it has a special need for management and planning. Special need management planning because it's an unique and it's a very resourceful, dynamic. Then you need management is much more important. Then the water is a major integrated force in the coastal zone. So coast means is the land meet to the water or sea. So that's the zone. So water is a major component in the coastal zone, and for any kind, because all the disaster to anything, it's coming from the water side. Okay, so that's, you have to properly manage it, then you can minimize the loss of the life to loss of the everything. So water force means it could be means coming from the ocean side, if you proper plan, then you can minimize the all the damages. Then the coastal zone land and water uses. So it's a zone between land and water. So land uses and water uses both the way, and jointly planned and management. So you can take resource from the water and you can take resource from the land. So because it's a transitional zone, so it's required for jointly manage and plan. And then sustainable development of coastal resources is a major purpose for coastal management and planning. Okay, and the multiple use of renewable coastal resources is basically emphasized by the coastal management and planning. So there is a huge importance of the coastal resources, multiple uses of coastal zone that should be properly managed in a sustainable way. Now the regulation. So government have the lots of rules and regulation. The few regulation that will be help to manage the ICDM, basically the critical ecosystem. If you declare a ecosystem is a critical ecosystem, that you have too much more protection on it. The critical ecosystem or fragile ecosystem like the mangrove, coral reef, they are basically very much sensitive are critical ecosystem. That should be you cannot means you have much more proper plan to prohibit from the destruction. So you cannot extract the mangrove plant from there. You cannot coral mining is not prohibited. So regulation should be on that way, and the fishing should be managed. So you cannot fish unsustainably. So that's why total TAC, total allowable catch, minimizing cut of the size of the fish. So you cannot capture all size of the fish. So the which are the young fish that should be removed. Okay, that you cannot catch this. Then the closer season, then the harmful fishing methods are like prawn net is already banned in the Oman. It's a good. So that kind of management or practice means rules and regulations should be implemented and should be monitoring regularly. And the aquaculture should not be done in the expense of mangrove. So you are preparing an aquaculture farm by cutting the mangrove. So that could not be. So you have to keep the mangrove as well, mangrove habitat. You also prepare the aquaculture plant or aquaculture farm in away from the mangrove forest. And because mangrove is much more important, we have talked about it, about the mangrove ecosystem, that what are the important of mangrove ecosystem. Then regulate the degrading activities and the other development activities. You have to regulate whatever the development activities going on the coastal zone. You cannot give the permission of a development in coastal area that is in a proper unsustainable way. So proper planning and sustainable way, then you can make a development within the coastal zone. And offshore oil cleaning, it's oil threats or oil spilling is regular a biggest threat to the coastal zone, and the, also the littering activities. Maybe you can't pollution is also you can minimize by proper regulation. Then erosion, so coastal erosion, then limiting setback of the coastal zone construction. You cannot line, setback line means 200 meter, 500 meter away from the coast, the coastal zone, or the true high tide level or line, or the true coastal zone from this zone meter or 500 meter, 200 meter, you can prepare, so you can make a construction or any development. So within that line, you cannot, so that is called basically setback line. Setback line, limiting setback line, any kind of coastal construction, and regulating the mining of sand dunes and all the sands. You cannot when mining of sand is basically a biggest threat of the coastal erosion or threat to the depletion of the coastal zone. And EIA, environmental impact assessment, very important. EIA is a very much important before planning any kind of large coastal project. Okay. And so here is, it's an integrated approach. So we'll talk about what are the all sources, means all are coming to manage a custodial resources. So it could be coming, so what are the approaches? So you have to mangrove ecosystem, so plantation of mangrove and its associate species, and then uses of adaptive technology. You have to use the technology, then the municipal solid waste management, then livelihood security, pollution, then the environmental monitoring, EIA, already I have talked about. And then the second, aquaculture system, coastal aquaculture, then the fisheries production, value addition to the fisheries, so it gives you a much more economic profit. Then the livelihood option, it's not the fisheries. When the fishing banned, then you have to give you alternative livelihood. Then the scientific research, much more important, okay. Then the protection of fragile habitat like the mangrove coral, these are the much more fragile, so protection need. Then the install the agroforestry system in the coastal zone. Then the protection of turtle habitat like the Russell Head, it's very much important. And no construction at the surface. You like the you cannot construct in within the shore or within the beach, so no construction at the surface. Then the community awareness is much more important, much more important. People should be aware about the resources, importance of the coastal resources, okay, and the ecotourism, that tourism should be a sustainable way and properly managed, so that ecotourism is much more important for the coastal zone management. So that's all about the JDM part 2 video, and thank you.